We continue now at the top of Daf Yadalim and Beitzah Meseches Beitzah. This is Beitzah Daf 14b. And the previous summit, the Gemara had asked a contradiction in Brises. In one Brisa, it implied that even with a Machteshes Katana, even with a small mortar and pestle, you're not allowed to grind. In another Brisa, it seemed to imply that with a small one, it's allowed. And so the Gemara says it's talking about Anyantif. And so the Gemara now gives another answer to this contradiction. Rava Amar, Rava says, Lokash, it's not difficult. Halon Vahaluhu. It depends if you're talking about for us here in Bavel or if you're talking about for them in Eretz Yisrael. Rashi over here says, Rava Omar, Rava says, Liola Matam Koamar, Uviktano Nami Koi Vikomar in Koshin Klal. That first Brisa was saying, even with a small one, you're not allowed to grind. Uduramino na Lohaval Koshin, and the other Brisa, which seemed to say you are allowed to. So, Halon de Leslon Avde de Mizalzli. For us in Bavel, we don't have a lot of servants. And these servants, they don't take seriously the halacha, but we don't have a lot of servants. So we don't have to worry. So we can permit it with a small one. Halahu, but for them in Eretz Yisrael, the Islu Avdi, they have servants. The Mizalzli, Vosin Begadola, Viomer Bekatano Asinu. The servants will do it with a large machteshes, and they'll claim they did it with a small one. They don't keep the halacha so strictly, so they have to prohibit everything, even with a small one. And the Gemara continues, Rav Papi Ikla Levei Mar Shmuel. Rav Papi went to the house of Mar Shmuel. Isile Daisa Veloachal. So they brought him porridge, and he wouldn't eat the porridge. And so the Gemara says, why was he so strict? V'dilma b'machteshes katana avdua. Maybe they made it with a small machteshes, which we said was permitted. So the Gemara says, d'chazio d'havadayik tvei. He saw that it was ground very well, so it was clear that they were using it with a large one. So the Gemara says, v'dilma me'asmal avdua. But still, why didn't he eat it? Maybe they did it from the day before. Maybe they did it from yesterday, from before Yontif. So the Gemara answers, d'chazio d'havik kolif tzahari. He saw that the husks were bright, so therefore it indicated it was not done yesterday, it was done today. V'ibayisayim, and the Gemara says, if you want, I could say another answer. Shani bei mar shmuel, it's different in the house of mar shmuel, d'ika pritzusa d'avdi. Because again, there were servants in the house of mar shmuel, they didn't follow the halacha properly, so therefore he was more strict. The Gemara continues with the Mishnah, haborer kitnius b'yomtiv, let's say somebody is separating legumes, the good from the bad, on yomtiv. Beishamai omer, beishamai say, borer ochel v'ochel. He takes out the good, the food, and he eats the food, meaning he does it a little bit at a time, basically with a shinui. Beishilal omer, beishilal say, borer kedarko. He can separate in the normal fashion, becheiko on his lap, bekonon, uvetamchoy. He can use a tray, he can use a large vessel, avalo betavla, but he shouldn't use a tablet, velo benafa, he shouldn't use a winnow, velo bekvara, he shouldn't use a sieve. He shouldn't do it in totally the normal fashion, it should be a little bit of a shinui. Rabbi Gamliel Omer, Rabbi Gamliel says, af mediach v'shole, he can even rinse and skim off the top. Rashi over here says, mediach b'mayim, he rinses it with water, v'shole, mefarish b'gemar, the Gemara will explain, shola hapsola shetsof lamala, the bad part it ends up floating to the top, and then he's able again to skim it off from the top. That's what Rabbi Gamliel says is permitted. And the Gemara says, Tanya, we learned in a braisa, Omer Rabbi Gamliel, Rabbi Gamliel says, b'med devorim amurim, when is this true? Rashi over here says, b'med devorim amurim, Desharu Beisilah Litol Psoles Mam Mishul Hashlach. When is it that Beisilah say that the person can take the actual psoles, the junk, and throw it out? In what situation is that permitted? Kesheha Ochel Merubal Psoles. It's only true when there's more food than there is psoles, when there's more good than bad. Avol Psoles Merubal Ochel. But if the junky part is more than the Ochel, if the psoles is more than the food, so divrei hakol notel es ochel umeniach es psoles. Then everybody agrees you have to take the ochel and you leave the psoles. You take the good and you leave the bad. And so the Gemara says, one second, psoles meruba la ochel miika man deshari. If you have more psoles than ochel, is there anyone that would permit it? Is there anyone that would allow you to take the psoles? Of course you're not allowed to take the psoles in that situation. Rashi over here says, miika man deshari vafilu letaltelo vabeteli le miuta legabe ruba. Rashi says even further, Rashi says that if you have a majority psoles, then the entire mixture should be considered psoles, and therefore it should all be considered basically muksa. You're not allowed to move it around at all. And so the Gemara answers, lo tzricha, no, it is needed, dinovish betircha, there's a lot of burden to do it, vizuter b'shiura, but it is less in terms of the amount. Rashi over here says, dinovish betircha sheyesh no dak, meaning the psoles, it's less in amount. It's not that the majority of this mixture is psoles, but it's very small, it's very difficult to remove. So here's really what Rabbi Gamliel was saying. In a situation where taking the food is more difficult than taking the psoles, so then Beisilel say you should take the psoles. If you should always do less, do what's less of a tircha. Avalim Torah Hapsolas Maruba al Shala Ochel, but if the taking of the psolas is more of a tircha than the ochel, so divrei akol, then everybody agrees you take the ochel. But of course, we're not talking about the situation where the majority in terms of the quantity is psolas, because then the entire thing would be considered psolas. The Gemara continues at the two dots, quoting the Mishnah, Rabbi Gamliel Omer, Rabbi Gamliel says, Af meidiach v'shola, you can even use water and then skim off the top. And the Gemara says, Tanya, we learned in a braisa, Amar Rabbi Lozer, Rabbi Tzadok, Rabbi Lozer, Rabbi Tzadok said, Kach hayam min hagan shal beis Rabbi Gamliel. This was the custom of the house of Rabbi Gamliel. Shahayu mevi'in and delim mali adashim, they would bring a pail that was full of lentils, umitzifin all of mayim, and they would pour water on it, v'nimsa ochel lamato psolas lamala, and it would come out that the food would be at the bottom, and the psolas would be at the top, so they would skim the psolas off of the top. So the Gemara says, v'atan yibcha, but didn't we learn in a braisa the opposite, meaning didn't we learn that it was the psolas that went to the bottom and the food was at the top? And so the Gemara says, lokash, it's not difficult. Ha bi'afra, in one case we're talking about the dirt would actually sink to the bottom. Ha begili, the other braisa we're talking about the straw would float to the top. And the Gemara continues with the Mishnah, Beis Shammai Omrim, Beis Shammai say, Ein Meshalchin b'yomtev el amonos. You're not allowed to send gifts on yomtev except portions. Rashi over here says, Ein Meshalchin doro nishlarei, a person can't send a gift to his friend el amonos. What does monos mean? It means davar hamuchan, it means something that's fully prepared. V'enu asoy lanicho l'machar, it's not something that you leave for the next day. Kegon chatichos basar chatuchos, you have already cut meat, lefnei ha'orchem, before the guests, v'chein dogim, similarly with fish. That's the only thing that you're allowed to send as a gift on yontif. U'beisila lomer beisila say, meshalchen behema chaya v'of, you could send domesticated animals, wild animals, birds, bein chayin, bein shchutin, whether they're alive, whether they're shechted, meshalchen yenos, shemonim, v'siltos, you could send wine, you could send oil, you could send fine flour, v'kidneys, you could send legumes, avalotvua, the only thing you can't send, according to Beisila, is grain. Rav Shimon matar b'tvua, and Rabbi Shimon says it's okay to send grain. Rashi over here says, avaloes atvua, you can't send grain, she'ena ru'uya hayom, it's not fit for today, she'en tochenim b'yomtiv, because you're not allowed to grind on yomtiv. Shahayalo litchon me'asmol, he should have ground it the day before yesterday, he should have ground it before yomtiv, v'lo tofik taim, and it would not have lost any taste, so therefore you can't send that. For Rabbi Shimon matar b'tvua, Rabbi Shimon says it's okay to send grain, why? Shemi yevashlim b'kadera, because maybe he'll cook it in a pot. V'yichta shem b'machteshes katana, there is a way to grind it. You can pound it with a small machteshes, so therefore it's okay to send that as well. And the Gemara says, Tani Rev Yechiel taught, uvilvad shelo yasenu b'shura, as long as you don't send it b'shura. Rashi over here says, shelo yasenu b'shura lo yeshalach adorn al yedei anoshim harbe. Shura means that you're not sending it with a lot of people. Di'av shamil souvenirim kemolichim limchor b'shuk. Already, if you send it with a lot of people, it looks like you're carrying it to sell in the marketplace. It's too much. It's too much of a public display. And the Gemara continues. Tana was taught ein shura pechusa mishlosha b'nei adam. What's considered a shura? Basically, a row of people. It's not less than three people. It has to be at least three people to be a problem of shura. Boy, Rav Ashi asked, Tolosa gavri utolosa minemai. What if you have three people going, but they're each taking something separate? They're taking three individual items. What's the halacha there? And the Gemara says, Teku, that is left as a question. Rashi over here says, Tolosa gavri shluchim im tolosa mine. You have three shluchim together with three different portions that are being taken. Mai, what's the halacha? Miazlina basar kol min v'min v'shari. Maybe we look at each portion and say each portion only has one person, so it's okay. Ki echad yachol l'shloch ish echadim kol min. You would be able to send individually one person with one portion. So zeb below zeb, as long as they don't go together. So hashtanami shari, maybe now they're all going together. It's okay because they're taking separate items. Odilmer, maybe hashtami avshamil sari. If it's three going at one time, that's too much of a public display and it's going to be a problem. And again, the Gemara said teku. They had no answer to the question. And the Gemara continues at the two dots, quoting the Mishnah, Rabbi Shimon matir b'tvua. The Mishnah said Rabbi Shimon allows by grain. Tanya, we learned in a braisa, Rabbi Shimon matir b'tvua. Rabbi Shimon allows grain, kegon chitin lasos mehen ludios. For example, chitin, you can make ludios. Rashi just says ludios was a certain food they made from chitin. Sa'orim litein lefnei behemto, you send barley to put in front of the animals. Adoshim and lentils, lasos mehen resisin, to make resisin, also a certain food that's made from lentils. The Gemara continues with the Mishnah, meshalchin kalim, a person can send clothing. Bein tefurin, bein sheinon tefurin, whether they're sewn or not sewn. V'yaf al bishiyesh ben kilayim, even though they have kilayim, which would normally make it prohibited to wear. V'hein letzorech ha-moed, as long as it can be used for the moed, the Gemara will explain how it's going to be able to be used for the moed if it's kilayim. Avalo sandal ha-mesumer, but you can't use a sandal ha-mesumer. Rashi over here says, Avalo sandal shel eitz, This was a sandal made out of wood, mitsupa or, and it was made covered with leather, covered with hide. Umismaros kivuin bow, and they had nails in it. Shagazru chacham olav. That was a gezer the chacham made. Shalo lenalo b'shabbes, not to wear such shoes on Shabbos. Uveyamtiv or yamtiv mishamaisa shay, because there was an incident that happened. Shenergu harugim b'shabbes al yadav. People got killed with the sandal hamasumer, so they made a gezer not to wear. But Masechet Shabbos. This is a story in Masechet Shabbos. Velo minol she'eno tafer. You also can't send a shoe that is not sewn, because that can't be used for anything. Rabbi Yehuda Omer, Rabbi Yehuda says, Aflo mino lovin. You can't even send a white shoe. Meneshet sarich uman, because that needs a professional to darken it, to make it black. Zeha klal, the rule is as follows. Kol she'neosin bo b'yantiv. Anything that you can wear, that you can adorn yourself with on yantiv, mishalchino, so that you're allowed to send. And the Gemara says, Bishlama tfur, and I understand if you have clothing that are sewn, chazul amalbush, that's fit to be worn as clothing. She'ein tfur inami, and also if it's unsewn, chazul chasuya, you can use it to cover up, you can use it as a blanket. But if you have clothing that are kilayim, what are you possibly going to use that for on yontif? And maybe you're going to say that you can use it to put underneath you. You can sit on top of it. But the Braisa says, lo yale alecha, you can't wear kilayim. But you can put it underneath you. But the chachamim said, asur lasos kein, that you're not allowed to put it underneath. Shema tichrach lo nimal basar, because we're afraid that one of the threads will wrap around your skin. And so therefore, it's a problem even that. So what are you going to use it for? And maybe you'll say that you'll put it underneath you, but there'll be something separating between. It's not going to be directly underneath you. So Amar Rabbi Shimon ben Pazi, Amar Rabbi Yoshua ben Levi, Amar Rabbi Yossi ben Shol, but Rabbi Shimon ben Pazi said, in the name of Rabbi Yoshua ben Levi, in the name of Rabbi Yossi ben Shol, Amar Rabbi Mishum Kola Kadisha de Yerushalayim, Rabbi said, in the name of the Kahala Kadisha, the Holy Congregation of Yerushalayim, Afilo Eser Matzo, Zu Al Gabe Zu, even if you have 10 mattresses, one on top of the other, V'kilayim tachtein, you have kilayim underneath, Aser Lishon Alayim, it's Aser to sleep on them, so that wouldn't be usable for that either. And so the Gemara says, Ela Bevilon, rather what we're talking about here is a curtain. When you have a curtain that's kilayim, that can be used. You're not wearing it, you're not on top of it, it's not being used in any fashion that's prohibited, that can be sent on yontif. But the Gemara says, V'amar Ula, but didn't Ula say, V'mnei ma'amru vilon tamei, why did they say that a vilon is tamei? V'mnei sha'shamish mischamim kenegdo, because the shamish would sometimes use it, he would wrap it around himself in order to keep himself warm, so it's considered like a kli, and therefore it's tamei, so apparently it is worn. It should be a problem of kilayim, and we'll continue with this discussion in the next video on Daf Tezvav, Amud Aleph.